Tucson Unified School District's Mexican American Studies program has been shut down through the passage of House Bill 2281, and books related to the curriculum have been removed from the district's classroom. Producer Luis Carrion reports on a book caravan that made a special trip to Tucson to deliver books to students and teachers that are no longer in the classroom.
So, okay, you stood up as being American, right? But now you're standing up as being Chicano. How could you be both?
Mexican-American studies classes such as these are no longer allowed in Tucson's largest school district. TUSD's governing board voted to shut the classes down after the school superintendent ruled that they were in violation of a law that was once House Bill 2281. Attorney General Tom Horn is the architect of the bill, and he was in Tucson during a recent hearing on the case. He says the law will impose financial penalties to the district if they continue.
Technically, they're in violation because those courses are designed for students of a particular ethnic group. But the cases recognize that administrators have to administer laws with a certain amount of discretion and judgment. In this case, the only complaints we received were about the Mexican-American Studies program, and we received an overwhelming number of complaints that the course was taught in a racist way. We got zero complaints against any of the other courses.
TUSD was forced to eliminate the Mexican-American Studies courses through House Bill 2281. And, as part of the requirements, educators were asked to remove from classrooms all books associated with the curriculum. In many cases, this happened during school time.
While we were in front of the class giving the presentation, and they were taking the books out, and like she was making my teacher get the books and hand them off to her. And this was all going on, and we're over here trying to go with the presentation, so we're looking. And we're like, wait.
Crystal Echeribel is a senior at Tucson High School. She's proud to say that she's successful in academics. And she attributes much of her success in part to her exposure to the Mexican-American Studies program.
Our teachers.
It gave me a sense of family, and it gave me more motivation to actually go through with school. Because with a quote-unquote regular American history class, I couldn't relate to it with what, 2-3 pages of Bachovia didn't really explain anything to me. And it was starting to get like, okay, well, I want to know if, like, do Mexican Americans have any contributions? I started questioning a lot of things, and a lot of teachers didn't like that.
For the general election, you have everybody on the ballot.
Echeribel says one of the first things she did when she turned 18 is register to vote. She says she and her fellow students, many of whom are already accepted into college, want to ensure that a program that has helped them succeed survives the current debate surrounding ethnic studies.
Because this is where our history begins. It's over here, as Chicanos, as Mexican Americans.
On a recent Saturday, she attended an event downtown that was sponsored by a group known as Libro Traficantes. That's Spanish for book traffickers. They originated in Texas and brought to Tucson a supply of the books they say have been taken off the shelves in TUSD.
When we heard they had dismantled it, it didn't quite sink in until we saw accounts of young people who said that their teachers were forced to walk into classrooms during class time in front of them and box up books by our most beloved authors.
And we got a ton of books over there at the community center.
Tony Diaz led the Libro Traficante caravan that included people from various states. The list of authors removed from classrooms is not long, he says, but it includes literature that was considered important for the Mexican-American Studies curriculum. A curriculum that looks at the role of Mexican-Americans in the cultural history of American society.
So, and we plan to keep coming back.
He says that although the district says the books are not banned and are still available to the students, they are not made available to the classrooms.
But if they were to look up the word ban in the American Heritage Dictionary, the word ban is defined by prohibiting a book. And I'm sorry, the law, House Bill 2281, prohibits courses, which then led to a de facto ban. So whatever they want to call it, they're playing with words.
From what I've heard from the people that are with Libro Traficante, is the idea that they're going to bring back these books. Well, these books are already here.
Abel Morado is TUSD's assistant superintendent of high schools. He was the principal at Tucson High at the time the books were removed from the classrooms.
There is a stiff penalty connected to that, that if we were not compliant, then obviously we face sanctions from the state.
He says the administrators and teachers had to quickly figure out how to comply with the state mandate and take the books out.
So the direction was that we needed to eliminate them, we needed to change the courses, and then included in that was the acquisition of these books and needing to take them out of classrooms, which is never a good thing, and puts people in a real tough position. You know, it was tense, it was apprehensive, but at the same time, we were following through and trying to do the best job that we could.
According to Morado, the decision to remove the books from the classroom was difficult, but he says they are not banned and are available to students and libraries throughout the district.
The state superintendent's order did not extend to libraries, and I will say to you that we have not banned books. We had to remove them from the curriculum because they were part of the lawsuit.
They've made decisions that are fundamentally contrary to our own values. We don't ban books. They've banned books.
Richard Martinez is the lawyer representing the plaintiffs in an ongoing lawsuit where students challenged the legality of the law used to stop the teaching of Mexican-American studies. He says that currently the case is under review and anticipates that the judge will rule in favor of the students he represents. He contends that the books, in spite of the semantics that are used when discussing the topic, were effectively banned.
They took those books out of the classroom. They have prohibited, in writing, the teachers in Mexican-American studies from teaching anything from a Mexican-American studies perspective, from using any of their materials from a that was developed in the program, and from utilizing any of the written materials, including any of the books. That's banning.
Okay, we're an American government now, but that's different. But in American history...
While the debate of banned books continues, Martinez says that it is now up to the courts to determine the future of the Mexican-American studies classes in the Tucson Unified School District. A decision on a summary hearing on the TUSD Mexican-American Studies program is expected in about 2 months.